You know, one of the reasons the risk factors tend to occur more often in Black Americans is because of the environments and communities in which we are exposed. Picture, for example, the young child who grows up in a safe neighborhood with a large backyard where they can go out, play, and get exercise and walk around. And then picture a contrasting picture, a young child growing up somewhere where the neighborhood isn't safe due to crime, where the playground equipment isn't safe for them to play on. Those children growing up in that environment may be more likely to stay inside, watch TV, and eat snacks. And we see this divergence in risk factor patterns happening in youth. So it really does start with that child who has more or less access to exercise. And then as we age, this ends up magnifying over time. Adults who have jobs that don't allow them the free time to be able to exercise in their time off, or that don't provide enough income to purchase healthy foods, those people choose less healthy diets that put them at risk for high blood pressure, obesity, high cholesterol, diabetes, the ABCDs that we know lead to heart attacks and strokes.